Members of Jacob's Pillow in the audience tonight. Raise your hand if you're a member or a volunteer here at the Pillow. And if you are not raising your hand, please give a pat on the back to someone who is raising their hand, because, and let's give them a round of applause. We have about 2,500 members at Jacob's Pillow who support everything we do and make programs like Inside Out possible. Today, our members and volunteers enjoyed some awesome perks. We had a terrific garden tour with our horticulturalist, Valerie Loker. We had more applause, thank you. We had a beautiful open rehearsal with Dance Theater of Harlem. our members and volunteers are enjoying extra discounts in the store all night. If this sounds like something you would be interested in enjoying yourself, I heartily encourage you to visit one of the gals at the green table in the back, and they could help you sign up and become a member yourself, and you too could support all that we do here at the Pillow. Becoming a member is as little as $60 a year, and I guarantee you it's going to make you feel great. And I know this because I was here at Inside Out last night, and there was a little girl whose mom encouraged her to give a little bit of money at the top of the hill, as I am encouraging all of you to do now. And as she placed her donation in the basket, she did like a jump and a yippee. And she is proving what scientists and fundraisers like myself know, that giving makes you feel really, really good, because I know from talking to so many of you that you really love this place. So if that's worth the cost of a cup of coffee or a movie, I hope you will spend that tonight. Or if you want to spend $60 and become a member or more, we will gratefully take your donation, and we're going to do wonderful things with it, like bring you the kind of programming that you're about to see. Enjoy the show.
Hello. Welcome once again to this beautiful evening here in the Berkshires. My name is Laura Paige Kyber. I'm the program coordinator here. And before I introduce tonight's performance, I just wanted to tell you two things. That is, at the top of the hill, at the table, there is a free drawing if you'd like to fill out a card and put your name in to win some cool pillow prizes. You can do that there. Also, during the show, if you could please refrain from any photography, I'd be very much appreciative. And tonight, it's with a little bit of hometown pride, I am pleased to present the dancers of the Williams College Dance Department. They are under the direction of Sandra Burton, who got her MFA from Bennington College, just up the road in Vermont. She performed with the Chuck Davis Dance Company. She's been a board member and advisor for many cultural institutions, including Mass MoCA, NEFA, the New England Foundation for the Arts, as well as here at Jacob's Pillow, former board member. At Williams, there isn't actually an established dance major, so the dancers you'll see tonight don't get credit for what they do, but they choose to spend their time rehearsing and performing. So they're a really committed group, really excited. The way the dance, I just said there's no actual dance program, but the way it's structured is that in addition to the 4 credit classes that you can take at Williams, you can also audition to be a part of an extra performance group, a dance company. And tonight you'll actually see 3 different dance companies under the guise of the Williams Dance Department. Kusika is the first company you'll see. They study, focus on traditional African dance. CoDa, the next company, is a contemporary and ballet-focused group. And after that you'll see Sankofa, and they perform primarily step dancing, so percussive dance as it applies to hip-hop. I won't say much more than that other than enjoy the show. Please stay with us right afterwards for a brief question and answer session. And thank you all for being here. Enjoy.
Thank you. nous prendre na sobagia. Nous prendre na sobagia la. Sobagila dogweson mino. Sobagila dogweson mino. Avant d'entrer, faut nous jeter de l'eau. Eh, agoe. Na sobagia la. Sobagila dogwe san mino. Sobagila dogwe san mino. Avant d'entrer, mesdames avant d'entrer, papa avant d'entrer, mama avant d'entrer. Nous pour entrer na sobagia. Nous pour entrer na sobagia la. Sobagila dogwe san mino. Sobagila dogwe san mino. Avant entrer faut nous jeter l'eau.
Burton.
Thank you.
Thank you. Gosh, that last piece made me want to dance. So now's the part of the evening where we'll get to hear a little bit of their thoughts and your questions. And joining me up here, down below me actually, this is Sandra Burton, director of the dance department. And this is Janine Parker, the choreographer of the ballet piece that you saw.
I would also like to, before we go on, introduce Bashir Shakur, who used to be the co-artistic director of Kusika, the last group that you saw, Bashir Shakur. And also recognize Jason Lucas, who is a Williams College alum and a former member of Kusika. Also performing with us tonight are a couple of young people who just graduated, Kenny Jean in Sankofa, and Kelsey McDermott, who also just graduated. She's in Kusika. Our department is young. Dance at Williams is actually old. It was it came to the college in the 1970s when women joined the student body as something for girls to do in the physical education department. And one of the wonderful things about the students that Janine and I and our colleague colleagues Erica Denkmeyer and Tendai Muparutsa enjoy about these young people is that since those early roots, the dance took hold both among men and women, and going strong. We became an academic department in 2009, so in terms of the age of Williams College, 1793, we are quite young. We are building, and we are very proud of these young people. Also in the house are, we're really delighted and surprised by some young people who should have been up on this stage, like Peter sitting back there on that rock, and and several other people, meaning that they are very active members in these companies during the school year. So that's enough for me.
Yeah, I want to ask the dancers a couple questions. I was speaking with Sandra earlier today. She told me a little bit about some of the projects that you do throughout the year, particularly CoDa did a site-specific work at Mass MoCA, and she also explained that you've also performed in the Williams College Museum of Art. I just wanted to, maybe a dancer can answer this question, hear a little bit about what it's like to perform in these different venues and how that might be different or not, as to performing here on this stage.
Hey, my name is Rachel. I'm from Houston, Texas. So I've actually only been dancing for the past 2 years. And for me, I think dance itself is just something fun to share with everyone. So obviously, every venue is different with the audience, with the group of people that we're performing with. And for Kusika, we have live music, so every performance is different. But I think at the heart and center, it's always the same because we know the steps that we know, and we know that our purpose is to give joy to both ourselves and the people who watch us. So that in itself is just always the core of what I think dance is. So it's always different, but at the same, in the heart, it's always the same.
Great, great answer. I want to open it up to some questions from the audience. Just raise your hand and try and shout your question out nice and loud. I'll repeat the question so that we can all hear what you said, and then give the dancers a chance to respond. Questions from the audience. Yes, right? Oh, we have a little one right here. Go ahead. Great question. And I wonder the same thing myself. How do you do all those interesting moves? It's a lot of work.
Hi, I'm Randall Lotus. I'm from Orlando, Florida. It's honestly just a lot and a lot of practice. I mean, some of the things I see people do on the stage, I think I could never do in 1,000 years. But like, I only really started dancing when I came to Williams, and I thought the exact same thing. I can't do any of that. I could never try. But I went to tryouts, and eventually, you just get a community, and eventually you have a vocabulary. And so dancing kind of just becomes another way of talking. So it's pretty much just a lot of practice, a lot of imagination, and it's really fun. So it doesn't even seem like it's work.
Great. Right here, go ahead. This is a great question. He asks, since you're not dance majors, what brings you to the dance? Why these pieces? What's your interest, and how did you start doing what you're doing? Yeah.
Hello. My name is Marla Robertson. I am with Kusika. And what drew me to Kusika was the simple fact that I was dancing with another African dance company already. And I wanted to connect with the community in a way that was familiar to me. And Sandra talks about the working position in Kusika rehearsal in class all the time. And I'm personally interested in the links between agriculture and dance. And the working position is just what it means. You're working, you're bending your knees, you're articulating your torso. And we did a lot of that up there, in case you didn't recognize. So it's also for me getting back to my roots and connecting with a muscle memory that was there before I even knew it was there. So.
Is it possible for somebody from each company to address that question? Come on, Kate.
My name is Caitlin Mackeltz. I'm from New York, and I'm with Sankofa. So Williams College is a very small school, and there's not really much to do around there. Yeah, there's lots of studying, but one of my main favorite things about Williams are the people there, and I think the friendships that we form on the team together really inspire me. My favorite part is just dancing with the people that I love.
So, anybody from CoDa want to address the question? Thank you, Isaac.
Hi, I'm Isaac Johnson. I'm from Kaneohe, Hawaii, and I'm a dance major. Anyways, I started dancing in high school, didn't start ballet until Williams, but I mostly started doing it because my siblings danced a bit, and it was a lot of fun. But dancing grew to become something where I can express myself, and like, I'm sort of introverted, so it's hard to talk always, you know? But then, like, dancing, you can say whatever you want, and, like, there's no limit to how to express yourself. So that's why I dance.
So what Isaac is alluding to is that although our department is young and we don't have a major at Williams, we got permission last year to have contract majors, which means that students can create their own major in the dance department, and we support them in developing a thesis performance project. And our first two thesis contract majors just graduated this year and are continuing in the dance profession as dancers and choreographers. Isaac is also quite a wonderful developing choreographer in his own right. He's extremely strong and can do all kinds of flips and balances and counter levers with his training and his body. I had the pleasure of working with him all of last semester. He created three really inventive, site-specific pieces, solos, for himself as a challenge. I'd like for Vero to address this question because she choreographed the first piece that Kusika did.
My name is Veronique. I'm actually a chemistry major. but the first piece I created, I guess, is very good for me to talk about because it answers your question specifically. It's a piece that I created. I come from Haitian background, and the dance is a traditional Haitian dance. And I created it while working on a project, a Winter Study 99, during the month of January, where I was looking at tradition and what it meant, because my perception of what it was after doing my project was apparently wrong. And so what I found out was that tradition does evolve, and it does change, and it does influence, and that's how it stays relevant. That's how it is tradition. And so that project I engaged in because it was a way for me to find out more about myself, coming from that Haitian background and coming from a family that where that type of dance and that type of song is very, very important in maintaining our own family history. And so dance for me in that way was served as kind of a mirror, me looking into a mirror and me finding out more about myself, about my heritage, about my place in my family, about how I would be able to maintain that tradition while being 20, while going to Williams, while living in the Purple Bubble. I'm from New York City. Just being a method for me to keep track of all those things and bring them all together. So that's what dance is for me.
I think we have time for maybe one or two more questions. Yeah, go ahead in the white shirt. Great question. She is asking directly to the dancers what it means to them to perform here at Jacob's Pillow.
Hi, my name is Phoebe, and I'm with Sankofa. So my teammates are tired of me saying this, but my family has come here every single year, like, throughout my childhood. And when Sandy told us that we'd have the opportunity to perform at Jacob's Pillow, I was wildly excited, and, like, most of our, like, I was like, why, like, what? And, like, this, we've come to the stage, like, it was so exciting. And, like, a lot of us had never heard of Jacob's Pillow before, like, despite our dance background. And, then Sandy kind of gave us a brief history. Sandy didn't give us a history of what Jacob's Pillow is and kind of like the enormous amount it means to like the greater dance world. And it's just become this like a lot, the whole dance department this year, it's been a really big year for the dance department. Like we performed at Nick Cave had an opening in New York and we performed there. And like it's been a really big year for the dance department, like connecting to the wider world of dance. And like the fact that we're here, that we were invited here, like, I mean, there could be no higher compliment or like honor or like affirmation that what we're doing is real, kind of. It's a huge honor to be here.
Well, that's a tough one to follow, but one more question. Sure, go ahead. Yeah, absolutely. So he had a comment first and then a question. He loved the live music component to the performance. And then he wondered if about a connection that he saw that you have directly with the performers. Maybe you could talk about that interaction on stage.
Howdy. My name is Jason Lucas. I'm from Chicago, Illinois, Williams College, class of 02. So I'm a bit removed from these guys, but in my entire history, I'm a professional musician in New York City now, and coming up here to play with these guys, it's inspiring for me, primarily because, you know, dance and drumming out in nature it's a part of who we all are, and these lovely young women and young men are expressing themselves, and we are sort of creating the canvas on which they can do that. And it's an energy transfer. And When they're tired and they look at us and we know that the dance is going to be a little bit longer, it's it's an energy transfer in terms of of support, of love, of care, of encouragement. And being a Williams student and working so hard at your studies, you work hard and you play hard, and this is the play hard part. And it's a good transfer to know that there are people who are of like mind, who don't have the same major as you do, who come from someplace completely different, who may be of a different worldview than you. But when you're on stage, when you're working together, when you're making music, you're singing songs, or you're dancing together, all of that just melts away. And it's a sharing of energy between people that has no parameters on it. And that's the fun part, because you feel compelled to do it and you want to give your all to it, because it's just, it's fun. It's pure expression with no filter. So that's my part.
Well, my name is, again, Bashir Shakur, and being in a company can be a tough job. Like you said, we were trying to express so much energy in everything that we feel. We're trying to, without words, I think Isaac said it too, without words, we're trying to express how we feel without talking to you. But the dance and the rhythm, they live together. They're never separate. So the last piece that you saw was named Kassa, and it's from Guinea, West Africa. And it's a dance that traditionally that has its roots in, it's like you celebrate the hunting, you know, and you celebrate you coming home with food. And so the women would dance this. And then so some of the movements you saw, we were connected to the rhythm and also the movements. So you heard that in some of the music. And so you have to know what they're gonna do. You have to know what they're gonna do and try to do your best to keep up. And like Jason was saying, we're always transferring energy from us to them, and them to us. So that's sort of our role too.
I'd like to introduce Janine Parker, who is the dance department's ballet mistress and also a choreographer. And one of the things that we are beginning to build to do is to get to a place where our students, although they have specific interests, begin to move into an area of common training, and common training that also has a broad range, because dance has, as you know, many traditions and many voices, and dance is always changing. As Vero said, one of the things that we celebrate at Williams is tradition, but a tradition that is alive and breathing, not a tradition that has dust on it, okay? A tradition that's alive and breathing and in the body and in the mind and in the spirit of people who are learning. So that's the kind of community that we're about trying to foster in terms of our dance department.
Well, I want to extend one more note of thanks to the dancers, to you all for being here. This has been a really interesting discussion. Thank you all for your questions. And on that, if you're new to Jacob's Pillow, you might be wondering, what else can I do tonight? There will be a pre-show talk before both of the performances in the theaters tonight. We have Dance Theater of Harlem and the Ted Shawn, and Reggie Wilson Fist and Heel Performance Group and the Doris Duke. If you don't have tickets, you can stop by the box office. There's also the Pillow Pub if you're looking for a drink or a bite. Thank you all for being with us this evening. Thank you all for performing. It's lovely.